गुड आफ्टरनून, बिजनेस स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। हेलो, बिजनेस स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। हेलो, मैं अवेलेबल। हेलो हेलो, क्या
देख लीजिए।
ओके ओके, सो लास्ट वीक वी विल टॉक अबाउट लाइक is what we have seen in the last class. So last time I think we have started from this subject, right? So we can say like part of the network. You have more number of nodes, or you can say more number of PC connected to your network, right? Then for easiness or for easy communication purpose, the router itself will define the subnet, right? So depends on which type of IP address or class of IP address you have used, depends on that, right? This subnet is defined. So we have seen like your router will have a subnet mask, right? And how you create that subnet mask, that you have seen from one example, right? If you see this example, I have taken one example. I have taken one class A address, that is 11.6.65.27.1, right? So here, because of this class A, first 8 bits, so that is 11. That 11 value will define the network and remaining 3, right? That is 65, you will define the host, right? So here in subnet mask, right, you will take the first accept the first 6 bit, starting from 6 to 13 first bit, that index of the bit you will take as 1, and remaining the first 6 bit, that is 0 to 5, you take as 0, right? So that is, you can see in the binary form, right? And here to find the your subnet address, right, you just need to do the AND logic operation between subnet mask and IP address, right? So if you do that, then at the end of the result you will get 11.65.27.0. So here I have shown you like how you can do that AND operation. AND operation means if you find 2, 1, then only then you have to take 1, otherwise you have to take 0. 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, all those combinations you need to take only 0. Then we have seen the proxy server. Proxy server is a kind of, you can say, it's a middleware between the internet and your computer, right, or end user. So it's kind of the computer, right, and it's generally, whenever you search, go to some website, means you are accessing the data from that particular cloud of that website, or that if the website is of some company, then the cloud of or the server of that company. So that request will go from the proxy server, right? And from the your internet, right, that whatever data you are accessing, that will come back to your device through this proxy server, right? And this proxy server may block the data if you find that it has some antivirus or some hacker kind of thing, right? So the main two purpose is like it will keep the system behind to it, right? So internet will not know your system, right? And it will also use for speed up purpose. So if you have access some website, right, in the past, then from that is stored in the cache memory, and from that it can directly access the data, right? So it is the main two function of the proxy server, right? Then we use the firewall, right? So firewall, it's again, you can say like firewall may be software, it may be hardware, right? It is not kind like so it's always software. And nowadays, whenever you purchase some computer or PC and you install the OS, right? So OS, this firewall is by default installed. So I think I have shown you in the last lecture, like if in your PC, right? Like I am using Windows 7, so if you go to setting, so if you go to in the control panel, right, in control panel you find that option of proxy, firewall, right? Like here you can see like window firewall, right? So that firewall will generally provide the security, or we can say the protection from the antivirus or whatever the data is coming from the internet, right? And that you can update, right? Depends on, like, you know that every day some new virus, people are developing some new viruses, right? So it depends on that, your firewall also updating. So that we have seen, right? We have seen the function of firewall, right? How it works, how to use it. Okay. So the next topic is wireless sensor network, which is in short form you will know it as a WSN. So as you see in the name, it has a three word, right? One is the wireless, second is the sensor, and the third one is the network, right? So first word we'll see that is in center, it's a sensor. So if we talk about the sensor, then according to electronics engineer, right? What is the sensor? So sensor, you can call it as a device, an electronic device, which is used to gather the information from the environment, right? And that information may be some physical quantity, right? It may be some physical parameter, right? For example, the temperature, right? In the environment, you will find the temperature. So that temperature is one parameter. So you can use, you will find some devices in the market which can measure the temperature, right? For example, thermometer. So thermometer generally we are using, right? In the medical field, like if you have fever, then you can measure your body temperature using thermometer, right? So thermometer, you can call it as a sensor, which is used to measure the temperature of the body, right? So you can define a sensor is electronics device which used to measure some physical quantity, right? That is in the environment, right? So the user, the sensor is used to gather the information about physical process or physical phenomena and translate it into electrical signal. So what is the thermometer? Generally we will visualize the temperature. It has like a mercury which will go up and down, so depends on that we see like what is the temperature, right? So it is a sensor, but in wireless sensor network we are talking about the sensor which will, once it will sense some physical quantity, it will generate the electrical signal at the output. And because if you are using computer or you are using some microcontroller, so in that system definitely you need all the information in the form of electrical signal, right? So here that's why it's called, it's written like sensor will translate whatever the data it is measuring, that data is translated in the form of electrical signal, right? The term physical process of quantity, that is mean by any real world information like temperature, pressure, light, sound, motion, position, humidity, radiation, any liquid or gas. So all such real world information, all these real world parameter, right? That is mean by physical quantity or physical process. So we have I think in the unit 4 we have this sensor topic, right? We have sensor, type of sensor, some different basic sensor we will see in that unit, but the time we will go in more detail, right? So the first word is clear, right? Sensor. So and the network we already studied, right? Computer network. So network means when we connect more than one device, right, through wire or maybe wireless, in which and in that connection, through that connection we are exchanging the information or we are doing the communication. So here the meaning of network is, here the you have sensor and you have the sensor network means all the sensor, more than one sensor are connected in the network. So sensor network is a structure consists thing of sensors, computational units and communication elements for the purpose of recording, observing and reacting to event or a phenomenon, right? So here though we are call it sensor network, apart from sensor, right, specifically sensor, you also have some electronics devices, right, which may be part of your sensor or which may be you are using individual, right? So those devices you will use for computation purpose, you may use for communication purpose, right? So you can do some recording of some data, right? You can do observation, you can react means action, you can whatever data you have, from that data you will do some you can say you take some decision and you will react, right? So that is a sensor network. Then the event can be related to anything like physical world and industrial environment, a biological system or an information technology framework, while the controlling or observing the body can be consumer application, government, civil, military or industry and entity. So here this parameter or the physical world, which may be industry, it may be some biological system, means it may be your body, it may be your patient's body, it may be a body of some animal, or it may be a computer network or computer framework in which we are want to do some application. So that application may be related to the government, field of civil engineering, field of military or some industry. And here sensor network can be used for remote sensing, medical telemetry, surveillance, monitoring, data collection, right? So this wireless sensor network has a large number of applications. And the third word, the wireless. So here we have network of sensor, and that network, right, generally network, it may be of two type, it may be wired or it may be wireless. So here we are talking about the wireless network, right? So here the sensor are connected in the network, right, through Wi-Fi, through Bluetooth or through Zigbee or some RF technology, right? So there is no physical connection between the sensors. So these three quality or these three feature the wireless sensor network have, right? One is the wireless, right? The second thing is most of the devices are sensor, right? Some other devices are there like computation and communication. They are also part of sensor. So you can say like it's a network of only sensors, right? So the first one is it has sensor, second is the sensor is connected in the network, right? And the network is a type of wireless, right? So these three features is wireless sensor network. What are the wireless sensor networks? So typically sensor network consists of sensors. For computation, you may have a microcontroller or microprocessor, or maybe your computer as a central device. Right? The CPU of your computer you will use for processing or to take the decision. Right? So you have sensor, you have a controller. You also have some communication system, like your sensor does not have the facility to use, for example, Bluetooth. Right? So what you will do, you will connect a Bluetooth chip with your sensor. So that is kind of a communication system or communication equipment. So these three things are included in the sensor network. Right? Right, and here if the communication system in a sensor network is implemented using wireless protocol, then that network are known as a wireless sensor network or simply WSN, right? So that we have discussed. So the main domain is sensor network, right? And here specifically we are talking about only wireless sensor network. Means we are in this network we are using some wireless protocol. Maybe Bluetooth, maybe Zigbee, maybe RF technology, maybe Wi-Fi. So specifically, if I want to give the definition, then wireless sensor networks are a group of specified devices or sensors which are used to monitor different environmental conditions and to collect and organize the data at some certain central location. So here in this definition, you can include devices which are sensors, right? And we are use this network. Main our aim is to monitor some conditions, some parameter, or to collect some data. Right? And this data generally we organize, or we can say we store at some, or we send at some central location. It detects and measures a number of physical conditions like humidity, temperature, sound, pressure that we have discussed. Chemical. It may also measure some chemical parameters, right? And definitely here also, if your application, like you have to cover a large area, then definitely you need to use the internet, right? Otherwise you can make a network of some limited number of sensors, right? You can use it. So in this wireless sensor network, there are two main concepts, right? One is the sensor, the devices, which is generally known as a node, right? So whenever you read or you see the word a node, so that node means an electronics device, and most of the time it's sensor, right? So that is one thing, and second is the network, right? So as we discussed in the computer network, right? Now network have different type, network have different topology, right? So that way we will see also here. So there are a number of nodes in the sensor network, and these nodes are the detection station, and they are very small and portable. So as I told, one part of this wireless sensor network is node, right? So in your network you will find number of nodes, more than one node, right? And this node are generally the detection station. Means it they are for to detect some parameter, to measure some parameter, right? And these are generally are very small and are portable means you can change their position, right? You can take them from one place to another place. So there is a sensor or transducer, microcontroller, transceiver, and power sources in every sensor node. So if specifically I talk about a node, right? So generally the main purpose of the node is to measure some parameter. So it's just kind of a sensor work, right? So in a node you have sensor or transducer, right? Both are the similar thing. There is a minor difference, right, in sensor and transducer, right? That we will discuss in the fourth unit. But here, you remember the thing, like in a node, you have a sensor or transducer. You have microcontroller, and the microcontroller is for purpose of to take decision or to do some mathematical operation or to do some other kind of logical operation. Right? So for that processing purpose, we have microcontroller. You also have the transceiver. Transceiver means the combination of two things: transmitter and receiver. Right? It's a combination of two words: transmission, transmitter, and receiver. Right? So this transceiver means you have the facility, you have the devices which can transfer the data or which can receive the data, right? So kind of you can call it as an antenna kind of thing, right? Or if you use Bluetooth, means you have some Bluetooth chip, right? And the most important thing is all the nodes must have the power source, right? Because you know that all these are the sensor, microcontroller, then transmitter and receiver. All those are the electronics devices. So definitely, to operate them, you need some electric power. So these are the main, you can say, part or component which are included in a sensor node. Then the sensor, second is the microcontroller, third is the transceiver, and the fourth one is the power source. So the transducer or sensor sends the physical condition, and if there is any change, then it generates an electrical signal, and the signal go to the microcomputer or microcontroller for processing, and a central computer sends commands to transceiver, and the data is then transmitted to the computer. So this is the how the communication will happen in the wireless internet, right? And what is the main, what is the functionality of sensor, microcontroller, and transceiver? Then the type of wireless sensor network. Right? So we'll see it later. I have listed out some types like terrestrial wireless sensor network, underground, underwater network, multimedia network, mobile network. But apart from these, also some other types are there. So in the next lecture we will discuss all those types together. So right now I am skipping this part, types, wireless sensor network. Okay. As I told, like in the wireless sensor network, you have two main things to focus. One is the node, right? And the second is the network. So here, same as a computer network, here also the sensor network also have some topology, right? So topology and the computer network we have discussed, right? At that time we have seen like how your devices are connected in the network, and which way your devices are connected in the network, we are defining the topology, right? So at that time we have seen, I think, some six topology, right? Starting from bus, ring, star, mesh, tree, and hybrid. Right? So this topology we have discussed in the computer network. So same is those topology. This sensor network also have the topology, right? And in some literature you find this four topology. In some literature maybe you will find some only three topology, and that is the star, tree, and mesh, right? Because this mesh and point to point network both are somewhat similar. Okay, so these are the topology of wireless sensor network: point to point network, star network, tree network or tree topology, and mesh topology, right? So let's see one by one. So first is a point to point network. So we have seen in the computer network the architecture, right? Two types of architecture: point to point network, and the second was the client server. So here point to point means all devices are connected with each other, right? So in this topology there is no central hub. So this is opposite to the client server model. If you have client server model, then you have a central hub or central device. So here, as all the devices, all the nodes are connected with each other, right, there is no central hub, right? Or node can communicate directly to the another node, right? It do not need to go through some central hub or some central server. This is the most common topology used in the wireless sensor network, right? And it has a single data communication channel which offers a secure communication path. Here you can see in the figure, if you take any two devices, a pair of devices or a pair of node, you'll find a dedicated communication channel. So because of that, you this path is, you can say, the secure, because only single path is there. Here each device can act as a client and a server in it, right? So here there is no server, there is no client, so each device is act as a server as well as client. Okay. So these all topologies are similar to the computer network topology. They have the same advantage of those topology and disadvantage of those topology. Then the second is the star network or star topology. So unlike point-to-point network, here you will see like you have a central hub and all the nodes are connected to that central hub. So whenever you need to do some communication, you need to do to transfer the data from one node to the another node, the data should go through this central hub, right? So each communication is done through the centralized hub and no direct communication between the nodes are possible, right? So you can't communicate between two nodes directly. That is not possible. In this case, central hub is the server and the nodes are clients. So the star topology is following the client server model. Okay. And the third one is tree network. So here you will see from the figure, like you have the central hub means it is somewhat like star topology, and also you find like this central hub is connected to a root node. So here some nodes you will find like they are connected directly, so it's kind of point to point. So this topology is said to be the hybrid or the combination of point to point and the star topology. Here the central hub, here you will find the central hub, two central hub, one is the root node. So actually here the central hub is the, that is the root node. So here the central hub in it is called as the root node or called as a parent node, right? So here you have central hub, which is similar to the star topology, which are similar in the star topology. But in the tree network or tree topology, the central hub is your root node. And it is also called as the parent node. Data is processed from leaf nodes to the parent node. So here you will see the bottom, the six nodes, right? One is the first three are connected with the central hub, which is in the left side, and the three nodes are connected to the central hub, which is on the right side. So these six nodes, right, which are at the bottom, are known as a leaf nodes. So whenever they need to do some communication, right, to transfer some data, they pass the data to the root node through the central hub. The main advantage of this topology is less power consumption and compared to the other networks. Right? So that is one main advantage of this tree topology. Right? You need less power consumption. Topology. So here mesh. You know mesh means you connect all the devices with remaining all the nodes. Right. So it is mesh network. The data can hop from one node to another. All the nodes can communicate with each other directly without through any central hub. So this is kind of a point-to-point connection or point-to-point network, right? So this mesh and the point-to-point both are, you can say, the same topology. As you can find, like, all the nodes are connected, right? This is the most reliable structure of network communication, right? Because there is no single point of failure in it, right? And why no failure? Because for example, if there is a problem in the dedicated communication link, then you can see, like, you can also have the second link through some other node, right? So because of that, you will find some multiple paths between two devices, right? There is very, you can say, very less chance of failure, or probably there may occur the problem of communication link. But this structure is very complex and require a lot of power consumption. Right? So as you can see, like, all the devices are connected with each other. Because of that, the network, you will find the structure of the network is very complex, and also it will use more power. So it require a lot of power consumption. Right? So this, we can say, like, disadvantage of this network. It has one advantage is, like, there is no single point of failure, that is its advantage, and the disadvantage is this, it's very complex and it needs more power to operate. So these are the topologies of wireless network. Right? If you see the application, then the list is very large. This is too long, but here I try to include some major application. So those applications are, one is in the disaster relief operation, right? The disaster management. Second is the military. You will find the application of wireless sensor network. In the environmental, you will find some application. In medical also, you will find the application. And home nowadays, right? Nowadays we have the home. We are also using this wireless sensor network. Okay. So let's open. So in the disaster relief operation, like if some problem will occur, right, in the environment, and that is natural, like flood, somewhere you find the flood, maybe somewhere you find heavy rain, right? Earthquake or some wildfire, right? So such kind of disaster related problem or situation, right? You can use the wireless sensor network to monitor the parameter related to that disaster, right? Or you can also use the data to control or to help some people or to help the environment. So here in the figure you will find, like, I have taken the example of wildfire, right? So whenever the wildfire will occur, right, using this, how you can use the wireless sensor network? So using the drone or some aircraft, you will draw the sensor, right, near to the fire, right, and this each nodes, right, each node will give you the data. Like, for example, for fire you will measure the temperature, so you can create a temperature map, right, and using that map you can overcome that fire, right? Or you can control that fire. So that way this wireless sensor network will be used in the disaster relief operation. Same way you can use such kind of network or this node in flood, in rainy, right? So in earthquake, you have to define like what data you want to measure. Then in the military application, wireless sensor network can be deployed rapidly and are self-organized. That's why they are very useful in the military application, right? To deploy or to develop a wireless network, right? It's very easy, or you can say like it's not require more time. And the network is self-organized. So because of these two feature, these wireless sensor network are used widely in military operation, right? And that is for sensing and monitoring the friendly or hostile motion. So you can sense and monitor the motion or some movement of your enemy, right? If you talk about the battlefield, then battlefield surveillance can be done through the sensor node to keep a check on everything in case more equipment, forces or ammunition are needed in the battlefield, right? So for that purpose also we are using the sensor nodes or wireless sensor network, right? The chemical, nuclear or biological attack can also be detected through this sensor node, right? So check to detect such kind of attacks, right? We are also using wireless sensor network. Here you see like one picture, you will see like an example is of sniper detection system, so in which this system will detect the incoming fire from through the acoustic sensor, right? So acoustic sensor means it's related to which, acoustic means it's related to sound, so based on the sound it will detect the data, the sound data, and through that it will make the decision, right? So through that you can detect the sniper, or you will find the location of the shooter, right? So the position of shooter can be estimated by processing and retrieving the audio from the microphone. So in the battlefield or in that specific area, right, they have deployed some microphones. So whenever somebody passing from that microphone, or they will do some like firing, at that time that microphone will receive that sound, and through that sound it will send the data to the acoustic sensor, and acoustic sensor, whatever electric signal is generated, that signal will go to the your controller, and your controller will decide like it's sound of your of any fire or some other sound, right? So based on that you can detect the shooter, or you can also find the position. We will use in the military application, then the environmental application. So such network have a huge number of application in the environment, right? So like if you want to track the movement of some animal, some bird, or if you want to record them, then also you can use this wireless sensor network. Right? They can be used to track and record the movement of animals and birds. You can also do the monitoring of earth, soil, atmosphere context. Right? What atmosphere context means? The you can say like the measure of the amount of the dangerous gases like carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide. So you can do also that. You can measure the what is the amount of carbon dioxide right now in the atmosphere, right? So if you have some industry nearby you, then you can also do that, right? So you can monitor the earth, soil, atmosphere context, right? In soil also you can measure some different parameters, like what is the pH value, how much and some other parameter which is related to the soil. Mm-hmm. So that is helpful in the agriculture, right? So by that you can have some application in irrigation, in agriculture. This network they can also use for detection of fire, flood, earthquake, and chemical and biological outbreak. Right? So that we have discussed when we talk about the first application, right? That is related to disaster. One example is like ZebraNet. So this ZebraNet, it's kind of a wireless sensor network, and the purpose of this system is to track and monitor the movement and the interaction of zebras, right? So in the wildlife, some animal like zebra, right? So for zebra, they have prepared a network and they give the name it's ZebraNet, right? And it's generally doing the, it's tracking and monitoring the movement and interaction of zebras, right? So that way they can take care of zebras, right? So such way wireless sensor network have application in environment. So here you can see like many things you can measure, like if you have rain, then you can also sense the amount of rain. If you have some animal, then you can also use a sensor on animal to track them, to find its location. If you have hello, how are you? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So here you can see in the picture, like you will have wireless sensor network to measure the electromagnetic waves. If you are talking about the megacity, then definitely you have many mobile towers, right? So which are generating the electromagnetic waves. So you can measure that value of that waves, right? If you have some bridge, then you can measure the vibration, right? So from that you can also measure the health of your bridge, like if there is a problem or not. If you have animal, then you can put the sensor on the animal, you can track its location, or from the movement you can do some prediction, like the animal need something or not. Then you can also measure the amount of rain. If you have some car, then you can add some sensor which will sense the heat. You can have the water meter inside house. So many sensors you have to measure the parameter which is related to environment, so you can develop some environmental application. Then in the medical application or in the health application, right, we can use the wireless sensor network, we can integrate them to monitor a patient, right? Also you can insert inside the human body as well as in the animal body, right? So internal processes and the movement also you can monitor, right? Or also you can diagnose. So that is also done using this wireless sensor network. You can do like, you can check on the drug administration in the hospital, in the monitoring patient as well as doctor. For that also you can use wireless sensor network. Right? So one example is like artificial retina, right? So this is a kind of wireless sensor node, right? Or part of, you can say, wireless sensor network, which is used or which helps the patient in the detecting the presence of light and the movement of objects, right? And they can also locate the objects and count individual light, right? So that is related to the vision, and it's kind of artificial, so generated by human. So it's kind of a wireless sensor network, you can call. So this is a medical application. Then if you talk about the home application, then you know, like today we have the sensor inside our AC, like automatically, like you set your AC at some 20 degree, then if more number of people will go inside the room, then the temperature of room will increase automatically. Your AC once the temperature of room will reach to the 20 degree, automatically it will switch off. So you will find the sensor inside your air conditioner. You also find some sensor in the refrigerator, in the microwave oven, vacuum cleaner. You may have some security system, like you have some camera at your home. And if somebody enters your home, right, main gate, then you directly get the notification in your mobile, and you can, whatever the camera is capturing, you can see that video in your mobile at the remote location. Right? So that way you can use the security system, right? Or you can also put some sensor, like whenever your gate of your home is open, it will send the notification in your mobile, so you will know like somebody is entering your home, right? In refrigeration also you will find some sensors, like for temperature purpose definitely it has, but along with that, like if there is a dedicated space for some particular item, like for milk, you have dedicated location, then if at that location you have not, your refrigeration will not found the bottle of milk, then it will send the notification in your mobile. If you don't have the milk, go to market and purchase it, right? So such kind of sensor are included. So that way we are using the wireless sensor network in home application, right? So as the technology is advancing, it is also making its way in your household application for the smooth running and satisfactory performance, right? So this wireless sensor network can be found in refrigerator, microwave, oven, vacuum cleaner, and security system, also in one water monitoring system, right? You will have the water monitoring system means. Nowadays also we are using, like whenever your water tank is empty, automatically it will switch on the motor, so your the tank which is at the top of your house, right, it will fill, and once it will fill, automatically it will switch off the motor, right? So the water will not waste it, so that way you can have the smart water monitoring system. The user can control the device locally as well as remotely with the help of wireless sensing, right? So you are from your office, you are going to your home, and you know, like to once you will switch on the AC, it will take some 5 minutes to reach to the whatever temperature you set. So what you will do, like whenever you are far from your home, some 5 minute distance, then from that location you will switch on your AC of your room. So when you will reach to your home, you will find your room, like your room will become the cool, right? So that way you can control the devices from locally as well as from remotely, right? So we have one unit of IoT, right? Internet of Things. So in that also we'll see this wireless sensor network is nothing but the part of the IoT, right? anywhere we can control anything. So at that time we'll see that in the detail. So these are the applications. We'll see in the figure, like from one remote, the person is controlling the light, controlling the door, controlling the window. We'll also controlling some the temperature, right? And we do some automation, right? So these are the application of wireless sensor network. So we'll stop here. In the next lecture, we'll see the types of wireless sensor network and some issue, right? So then we'll finish our first unit, and the next lecture we'll discuss about the slides. So at end of the each unit, we will arrange one test, right? It's kind of MCQ. So anybody have any question?